Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making a sandwich, and it's going to be turkey, brie, and peach. And it's one of the sandwiches that we ordered when we were at Jonathan's at Gratz Park in Lexington. And we went there, as we mentioned, just to kind of show you a very nice eating place because there were going to be floods of people coming in for the World Equestrian Games, and I'm sure all of those places downtown will have a lot of visitors, and I wanted you to experience some of the fine foods that are made even for lunch, and this was a lunch meal. I've already made the cheddar with yellow and red bell pepper sandwich, so this technique for the bread is about the same, so you might need to refer back to it because I'm not going to start from scratch on this one. But this was Rick's sandwich, and he and I both chose what they call brioche for the bread. That's a French bread, and I wasn't able to pick that up here in Richmond. So I have Italian bread that's a good shape and size for slicing, and you can see I have just sliced off part of it and put the rest back in the bag. And I will put that either, I'll store it somewhere and use it quickly, or I'll freeze it and use it in a couple weeks. But what I've done is already slice off two slices that are about the same size. They were consecutive in that roll. And I used some softened butter, like you see here, and put on the top side and on the bottom side. Just flipped it over. And then I went to the stove top and just let them brown up. So they're nice and toasty, and that was done over here on the stove. And then both sides had to be nice and toasty, and I tried to avoid having a lot of butter because I don't like them greasy. And if you don't want the butter at all, you can toast them in the oven, or maybe they'll fit in the toaster. But they should be toasted. I think it's going to be better that way, although we could have ordered our sandwiches with any type of bread, fresh bread, it could have been rye or whole wheat, white, anything. But this is what we chose. I'm going to try to stay true to our choices. So let me bring this over here to assemble it. And I guess it's going to go not quite like that. More like that, I think. That was the way it was fitting together. So we'll just fill one side and then put the other one on it. For the turkey, that probably should go on first, because I'm going to come back later and put lettuce and tomato as a dressing, and the other side's going to be a little sticky, so I don't think it's going to open up. But what I've done is gotten some deli sliced turkey. It's sliced an eighth inch thick, and what I've taken out from here are two slices and then folded them over, so the thickness here is four. And I cut off a middle section just so this would match the size of bread that I'm going to use. So if I take my four halves and put them along there, they follow the curve, and that works out pretty well. So that's about the amount of meat I would suggest that you put on there. So if it were not cut into 1/8 inch slices, if it were like 1/2 inch slice, then just take one of them, or half of one, and that would make that half moon shape and put it on top of your bread. All right, the next thing we want to put on here is brie cheese. Now I've opened this just freshly a few minutes ago and gotten into it, and you know it has a tough layer on the top. For this sandwich, we want to get down beyond that and get to the softer cheese. So for me, it was just a matter of going around the edge and then slicing a slice from the top. Let's see if I can pull this off. And then I use my knife to get a slice from underneath. It's kind of stuck back together. But I just took a slice from there so I could have the softest of what was there in the brie. So I have kind of a half moon shape there. So that's going to go next. It will be very sticky unless you keep it in the refrigerator until you're ready to use it. You might even need to stick it in the freezer for a minute. But it goes there. And then next, we had peach. Or Rick had peach on his sandwich. I didn't happen to have any of that here, peach preserves. But that is actually true to the sandwich. I'm using a substitute, which is apricot preserves. And these are sugar-free, so that helps a little bit. And this was light Brie, by the way, and turkey, of course, is a nice light meat. So this isn't as bad as you might think with the sweetness and the cheese and all. But just put a layer of that, just spoon it out and get it on there. And then what I'm going to do is put this in the microwave just long enough to melt the Brie cheese and combine it a little bit with the apricot preserves. And I'll be back and show you what I have. I want to show you what the microwave did for our sandwich. I left it in my microwave for 30 seconds at 60% power. So I did it 10 seconds at a time so I could check. I didn't want the bread to overcook, and it feels the same as when it went in, so it's still nice and fresh. But what you'll see is over here, you can see some meltiness of the cheese. That's what you want, and you want these preserves to be warmed up a little bit. And when you get to that point, you can put this half of the bread on and then turn it over. And you may drizzle some of that out, that's okay. But this will come off easily. That was planned from the beginning so that we could finish it up in the style of Jonathan's. And both sandwiches that we had were finished off with thin sliced tomatoes and some lettuce leaves. And you want to have fresh tomatoes and fresh lettuce. That the lettuce needs to be kind of outer leaves so that they are very thin and easy to work with. When you go to, this is iceberg lettuce, when you go to the center, it's going to be really crisp and crunchy and want to curl up. So if you can stay toward the outside as long as you can, then those go really nicely onto your sandwich. So it's really a quick sandwich to do, but it has that little bit of flair to it that you might not have otherwise. I think this is the side I had, or maybe it was that. I'm not really sure.
The other way.
Oh, it's the other way. That's it. Okay, so now, this time, I remember to get a sharp knife. So we're going corner to corner. Just a diagonal slice. This is much easier than gnawing through it with a table knife like that, which is what I did on my cheddar sandwich. So I would advise you, if you've seen both of them, go back and do that one. Just use a sharp knife and you'll be much better off when you make it. Isn't that a lovely sandwich? And that Brie cheese just oozing out of there. And it's a little warm. I can tell it's a little warm, but it's not hot. So lovely sandwich with what we showed you when we were eating out. The bread on the outside, toasted, both sides of it were toasted, and then the lettuce and tomato next, a good amount of turkey, not too much, and then the Brie cheese, and then this is peach or apricot preserves. And I'll put it over on this plate, and we can leave behind any mess that we have over here from making it and just display it like this. Isn't that a lovely sandwich? I think you'll like it.